Because it is my guilt, I claim you, grievous miracle. Make my chest hurt with regret. Forge your punishment and nail it deep. Shape my guilt once again.
And thus, guilt, repentance, mourning, and every pain of the soul of all kind were visibly and tangibly manifested everywhere and in all of us. Sometimes in the form of blessing and grace, sometimes in the form of punishment and corruption. That divine will, equally pious and cruel, which we could not and will never be able to unravel, was called the Miracle. Regretful be the heart, penitent one. The anguish of the eldest brother has now come to an end. I am Deo Gracias, witness to and narrator of the acts of the grievous miracle. Such is my penance, as yours is silence. The cradle of affliction is what you seek. This can be found in the mother of mothers of the churches. It is is a remote place separated from the rest of these lands by a great, sacred, and forbidden door. Even a wise penitent like me knows nothing of what lies beyond those high walls. However, what I do know is that, according to the rule, one must carry out the 3 humiliations to gain access to what they guard. One of them must be performed in the high mountains, covered in thick blankets of snow and ice. Another in the depths of a dark, entombed church where the sleeper lies. And the last one, at the end of the trail, carved by moans that claw their way out of an iron spiral, in the bowels of the bell named Hondo that grows into the earth. Take this thorn and place it on the handle of your sword. If, when the time comes, as you grip your weapon firmly, you notice that it wounds you and makes you bleed. Having grown, with more thorns sprouting from it, writhing over the figure of the father carved into the knob, that will mean that you are at the mercy of the Grievous Miracle, whether for its punishment or its forgiveness.
There is no answer to our plea. The miracle has forsaken us, and my ornate throne turns its back on those who await here.
Penitent One, you who carry the painful guilt in your cracked hands, lend it to us and alleviate our burden. Lend it to us and wipe away our tears. Because it is an act of penitence.
Thank you.
feel my blood turning into black sap, and my aged skin into reddish bark.
The Knot of the Three Words. Here is where the first miracle took place. One devout and tormented youngster asked the High Will for punishment. He placed a wooden log where he sat and prayed. He prayed hoping to be heard. He prayed for pain, so he could ease the guilt that sharply pierced his soul. Then, the miracle manifested itself. It made roots grow and twist over his arms and legs, but not a cry nor a complaint came out from his mouth. Every inhabitant of this land bore witness to it, and all of them prayed before the besotted eternal joy of that youngster. This triune tree that sprouted years after his death was named the Knot of the Three Words. For three are its twisted trunks, and three were the words spoken by that youngster before he died. My great guilt. Every year from its core flows a golden, burning liquid, perpetuating his memory, and perhaps to remind us that the first miracle has not abandoned us. For twisted are, were, and will be the paths of the miracle. Thank you.
I see everything from the highest point of the dried tree in which the miracle has reincarnated me.
Penitent One in sleeplessness. Carrying the guilty sword, you have committed the most serious crimes against the Mother and her saints, against the miracle and its outbreaks. We have been entrusted with putting an end to your mission. I, Chrysanta in penance, excommunicate you, expel you, execrate you with the blessing of our miracle of the greatest pain. And thus shall your name be erased under the heavens.
Thank you. In my dreams, I heard your footsteps coming closer. In my dreams, I tried to talk to you and introduce myself. Guardian of the miracle and of the miracle banner, with great pain, I carry the emblem of the Father. I am the hands of bloodied skin. I am the eyes from which our mother gazes. But nothing I know of you, apart from your cold, nameless visage, apart from your calloused and wounded hands, apart from the mourning of your deaths. No, I know nothing of you. Only the miracle knows. Now may your sword, full of guilt, with mine of gold, collide. Let them hurt and march in procession. I curse you forever in name. I bless you forever in death.
Freed His Holiness from his afflicted torment. And now he walks by the old processions on the other side of the dream. The cradle of the grievous miracle. The final relic. The grail of blood and gold that emanated from the forehead of the Father as he silently lamented the moment of his blessed twisting. That first relic is here, at the top of the Ashen Mountain, next to the Turn Throne, where His Holiness was kissed by a miraculous pain. And now, your final communion with the miracle awaits. Only you would be able to know how much of it has seeped into your guilty heart. sins and sinners alike, has had no mercy on you either. At the mercy of the miracle you were, and at the mercy of the miracle you remain. You are no longer anything but one more anonymous visage, without a voice, without a countenance. Your penitence is over.